The war in Syria has been raging and increasing Turkey's security concerns. Its NATO ally, the United States, is currently providing training and equipment to around 30,000 SDF members right near Turkey's border with Syria. The SDF are made up mostly of fighters from the YPG, which is actually an armed wing of an internationally recognized terrorist group called the PKK, which has been in armed conflict with Turkey for more than 30 years. Even the US recognizes the PKK as a terror group. And at one point, the former US Secretary of Defense, Ashton Carter, had this to say about the YPG-PKK link.
Secretary Carter, have you ever heard of the PYD?
I have, yes.
Have you heard of the YPG?
I have heard of them also.
Reports indicate that they're aligned or at least have substantial ties to the PKK. Is that true?
Yes.
The US says that they're just supporting a group of fighters against ISIS, also known as Daesh. But that's not the whole story. The SDF were fighting ISIS, but is this support still necessary?
There are very few of them left in that area of the world. And within another 30 days, there won't be any of them left.
Why train 30,000 militants who are enemies of one of your strongest allies in the region, right on their border, to fight a group you say is nearly destroyed? Experts believe the US wants to use the SDF and YPG as a proxy against Iran and Russia, maintaining military bases to conduct its operations in the Middle East. But there's more. The US is also building observation posts along Turkey's border in what it claims will address Turkey's security concerns, but Turkey sees it differently.
Yine Amerikan askerleri tarafından kurulan radar üsleri ve gözlem noktalarının hedefinin de ülkemizi teröristlerden değil, teröristleri Türkiye'den korumak olduğu aşikardır.
The US is not alone in their support for the SDF and YPG. In YPG-controlled areas of Syria, Saudi Arabia is sending forces and establishing checkpoints to recruit militants, and the UAE is also sending forces to help. So now Turkey, trying to protect its border and security, is entering Syria once again to clear the area of YPG terrorists. Like all battles in Syria, it's complicated because it involves so many parties. To get beyond the impasse, allies need to work more effectively together.